What is up, everyone? This is Victoria here. I am here at the very first Jollywood Nights ever. So this is a hard ticket event that is the first time ever happening at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Now, I have been looking forward to this event all year. It's more adult leaning, but it's gonna have so much entertainment. They're gonna have a Muppets variety style show. They're gonna have a Nightmare Before Christmas event. We're asked to dress in our Dapper best. We're gonna have so much food to try. There's gonna be characters, there's gonna be so much to do. I hope you're digging the outfit. I'll give you a better look at it later. But right now I'm here with my friend Courtney. I know a ton of my friends are here, so we're probably gonna run into them on the way here. But the first thing we're going to do is head over to Muppets. I cannot wait to see this amazing variety show. Now, this event is a separate ticketed admission from your regular park admission, so it is actually sold out. Oh, there's Courtney. But yeah, she had to get water. We had to get water. We're gonna get hydrated. Everyone looks freaking amazing. And I'm excited, yay! Jollywood Dog! So we're gonna get in there, get hydrated, and let's go do Muppets. Let's go! Can't wait to show you everything that we're going to experience tonight. All right, so we just got into the queue line for the holidays in Hollywood. It's not terrible. We got here about like 7:30. They're gonna open the first show at 8:15. Holidays in Hollywood show here at the Theater of the Stars. This is normally where the Beauty and the Beast show happens in Hollywood Studios, but this time it's going to be the Muppet variety show that features Kermit and Miss Piggy. It also has Princess Tiana, Belle, Mickey, Minnie, and other friends. It's going to feature a live band and dancers as well. So I am so excited. This is the very first showing ever of this show, and I am with all my friends.
Good evening, everyone. Happy holidays. We have got some truly fabulous entertainment in store for you today. We have music, we have dancing, we have special guests from far and wide. And now, put your hands together for Disney Holidays in Hollywood!
Hey,
holidays in Hollywood. I am Kermit the Frog, here with the fabulous Miss Piggy, and we are so honored to be co-hosting this magical musical show for all of you tonight.
Bonjour! Yes, tis moi! The greatest gift of all this holiday season. It must be such an honor for all of you to have moi here tonight.
Piggy, I said the honor was ours.
Huh? Oh, right. I suppose it is an honor for you and the rest of the cast, too. Well, look at me. I'm just honoring everyone here with my presence tonight. But I guess that's the spirit of the holidays, isn't it?
Sure. Let's go with that. But when I think about what the holidays mean to me, it's sharing the magic of the season with the ones we love most.
Aww. And that's why you're here with moi tonight. Isn't it, Kermit?
we're here because we were both invited. And because there's no better place to spend the holiday season than Walt Disney World.
Sure, dear. Well, when I think about what Christmas means to me, I think about presents.
Really? Just presents? There's so much more to the holiday season than gifts, isn't there?
Well, sure. But come on! We're literally standing in a pile of presents, clothes, shoes, and toys for all the little piggies and froggies out there who dream of being just like you and Walt.
You're missing out on the best parts of the holidays. Sure, this is the season of giving.
Ah, the season of giving me gifts.
Pretty sure that's receiving. But what I'm trying to say is that some gifts don't come in boxes and pretty paper.
Well, that's a great point, Kermit. And maybe all those children out there are looking for the kind of gifts that live inside here.
Yes, like Kermit's warm heart and generosity, or your bold sense of self-confidence, Miss Piggy.
Aw, thank you so much for noticing. Wait, who are you again?
These are just a couple of friends who've come to help us put on a great show this evening. Come on, everybody.
Toyland, Toyland, fill up your hearts with Joyland. We hope this season spirit brings you everything you need.
That makes sense, but we're kind of in the middle of a production here.
Well, I don't make the rules. I'm just the talent.
Wait, you are the talent?
Yes, Piggy. This is...
Brandy.
And...
LB.
And they're our fellow co-hosts for this evening.
Our fellow what? How many hosts does this show need? How big is your trailer? Yours didn't come with a jacuzzi, did it? Because I explicitly asked for one, and I did not get one.
We'll be back, folks. Probably. Okay, come on, Piggy. We better start digging our way out of here.
You did? Oh, all right.
And we are out. We're at commercial, folks.
This program is brought to you by Goofy's Candy Company, your one-stop shop for stocking stuffers this holiday season. Have you ever had one of those days where you
Good evening, everybody. We are so grateful that you've decided to be a part of our studio audience for this live holiday TV special.
Yes, yes. And we just heard Kermit the Frog and Miss Piggy talk about what the holidays mean to them. And I think Miss Piggy was onto something when she was talking about presents. So, in the spirit of giving, I would like to gift you all with the gift of stand-up comedy.
No, LB, we don't have time for that. It's not that long of a commercial break.
Wait, we're back in 4, 3, 2.
Welcome back, everyone. You know, when I was growing up, my family moved around a lot, so we spent Christmas in different places all over the country. Every year was somewhere new. New York, Chicago, New Orleans.
Hey, my grandma grew up in New Orleans.
Oh.
She used to tell all sorts of amazing stories about the Christmases down there.
Oh.
The bonfires, the smell of Creole food wafting out of every restaurant. Oh, she said on Christmas Eve, the best Réveillon dinner in all of New Orleans was at Tiana's Palace.
Oh, she's right. That place has the best beignets, and it's such a party at Christmas time.
Oh, I can only imagine.
break is brought to you by Figgy Pudding. What is it? We don't really know. But we know you won't go until you get some. So try some today.
Kermit, what is that on your head?
Oh, it's a Santa hat, Figgy.
Dang on that. Where did it come from? If this show has costume changes, I think someone in wardrobe would have told more.
Trust me, I know. Anyway, I just found this hat backstage.
Well, that just won't do. I didn't have any time to accessorize between numbers, and I refused to be upstaged.
I could never upstage you, Figgy. Listen, how about I make it up to you by getting you a churro and a spirit jersey after the show?
Throw in a giant pretzel and you got a deal.
Done.
Now we're talking.
Aren't they the best? And now, as a special treat to all of you here in our live studio audience, give it up for our house band, the Jolly Eight.
With some pipe and hot cocoa.
See the blazing
and three, four, I swallow, la 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 la. Here. Better get to it now before the snow gets any deeper. Oh, wait till you see this, Minnie.
I would have to say, being a part of this TV special with all of you here, this is a memory I will always cherish.
Yeah, know what you mean. We're creating memories. Memories that we can cherish forever.
Yeah.
And we're back in 4, 3, 2.
This time of year, the greatest gift we can give isn't something you'll find on a shelf. It's something we find in each other. Let's be honest. The world we live in can be more than a little chilly. But the belief that better days are coming, that's what counts. Because the greatest gift of all is hope.
Mistletoe and snow, winds come and go, much deeper than snow, stronger than the strongest love we'll know, we'll ever know. As long as there's Christmas, I truly believe that hope is the greatest. Gifts we'll receive. As long as there's Christmas, we'll all be just fine. A star shines above us, lighting your way and mine. As long as there's Christmas, I truly believe that hope is the greatest.
Holidays mean to me peace and warmth.
Yeah, our friends and family, those old traditions, singing our favorite song.
Let's do it!
Dancing through the snow, in a land of hearts open sleigh.
just got the first ever showing of the Disney Holidays in Hollywood show that is the Muppet variety television style show. My first reactions are absolutely, I loved it. It was definitely new. It was definitely something different. Tiana has a brand new dress. Belle sings As Long As There's Christmas from the iconic film. There's just so much in there. It's very funny. It's very heartwarming. I absolutely adored it. So next, we're going to head on over to the Twilight Soiree over at the Tower of Terror Courtyard. They have specialty cocktails over there and a live band. So hopefully we can get in. Capacity is a little limited, so we'll see what it looks like over there. Tower of Terror Courtyard.
Does anyone have any expectations for this?
I think it's going to be a quick grab your drink, look around, and scoot on out.
And scoochie.
Yeah, I think it's a quick turn and run.
Well, we shall see.
It's an alcoholic beverage.
What is?
Oh, what? The bottom one. I don't know, they have non-alcoholic.
Well, I'm in about three.
So we had quite the wait to get into the Twilight Soiree bar. They do have a few tables out. They open up some of the backstage area so that way some people can have some places to like stand and drink. But I would say it was about a 15-minute wait to get drinks at least. But as a reminder, if you're going to get a drink over at anywhere in Disney, it's a limit of two per person. What do you think? All right. That good?
It's juice.
I was hoping to be a little more bubbly.
Oh, that's cool. Look at that.
Oh, the washed out.
Wow.
So I was able to grab the Disney Jollywood Nights tee. This is actually the only piece of exclusive merch for the event. They were basically handing out sizes. The cast members were asking me what your size was. It is $30, but with my AP discount, it was going to be like, what, 20?
Yeah, 26.
26, so not terrible, but a little disappointed that in the lack of merch for the event.
Oh, this is always my favorite.
I love them. They're my favorites.
Yep.
All right, we are here in the Latin Street Fair. I'm actually still looking, so is it okay?
So
a big draw for the event is the food, and I finally managed to get in somewhere where the food isn't long, so we got to the Latin Street Fair section. I ended up getting some birria tacos, I got some Mexican hot cocoa cheesecake, and I got a old fashioned. So let's try it and see how it goes. So you see it's a decent amount. So I just tried the birria tacos. It does have quite a bit of beef in it, which I do like. I like the broth that they gave me for it. I kind of wish you got two instead of one, but you know, it's a good taco for the most part. All right, so I just tried out the Mexican hot cocoa cheesecake. It's not too rich, it's decadent. I do like the presentation of it. It's very good. I definitely like this particular dessert as well.
All right, so what did you get?
Some sort of empanada and pork belly.
Ooh, okay, so we had what so far? The street corn?
Yeah, the street corn's good.
Okay.
It's got limey taste to it.
Oh, it has like a lime.
Which is good, but yeah. That's what street corn's supposed to taste like.
Okay.
These were really good. They're the yucca french
the fries.
Haven't tried the pork belly yet, but it's got a bit of a spice to it because this lime has all kinds of chili flakes on it.
Oh.
No, it's not chili though. You put it on mangoes.
Okay.
And then, I don't know, and then whatever these are.
The empanadas? Probably beef.
Oh, chicken.
Chicken? Oh, okay.
Oh, those are good.
Okay.
Those are really good. I'm glad I got those.
All right.
Let's have a very merry Christmas. Make sure the party is together. There's no saving seats. Only for the couple.
Hello, my friends. What a wonderful sight. Let me welcome you all on this fine Christmas night. Now, you've heard the old story. We all know it well. But that's not the story I came here to tell. Every now and again, often more than it seems, when your eyelids are heavy and fated for dreams, A new sort of story just might be in store. When the mind is a forest and you've opened a door. Like the scene you see here, at a first passing glance, might seem ordinary, yes, or plain happenstance. But such wonders emerge where reality thins, and that is where our story begins.
Seems to be good feeling around. Instead of screams, I swear I can hear music in the air.
The smell of cakes and pies are absolutely everywhere. The sights, the sounds, they're everywhere and all around. I've never felt so good before. This empty place inside of me is spinning up. I simply cannot get out. I want it, oh, I want it, oh, I want it for my own. I've got to know. Thank you.
Out of the last Nightmare Before Christmas show. Courtney really liked
it. I loved it.
She said she liked it more than Muppets.
It was so good. Oogie Boogie and the Jack Skeleton puppet. It was great.
Oh yeah. I liked it. It was very cute.
The music's so good too.
Yeah. So that was an interesting way to end our Jollywood nights. We did get rained on. We were able to manage to get this awesome popcorn bucket, which is exclusive to all four parks, that you can get for $28. So there's that. But for the most part, the party's pretty much over besides Jingle Ball Jingle Bam. My initial thoughts were I'm giving it grace because it's its first time ever for its first night. So I'm giving it grace, but I feel like if they added maybe one more show or a few more characters, it would help even out the lines, just because a lot of the time, a lot of people were waiting in crazy lines for food, which was a big draw. So otherwise, I think the event definitely has potential for sure. I really enjoyed the shows and entertainment that we saw. Do you have any thoughts?
I love the Nightmare Before Christmas.
She loved the Nightmare Before Christmas.
Love Nightmare Before Christmas.
So, yes.
Boogie Boogie, because that's the first time he's been seen here, right?
In Hollywood Studios.
In Hollywood Studios, yes. Okay. And the Jack Skellington, the big one.
Also at Monster
Scare,
one. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, the sing-along was very well done. I like the interpretive take on it for sure. The Muppet Show was definitely my favorite though. That's right up my alley.
I
ate that shit up.
That was good.
But otherwise, I think that's gonna do it for us here at Jollywood Nights, first time ever. Yeah, like, follow, subscribe, support black people, you know.